students, in this video we will see how to solve the example based on LR0 parser. For the basics of LR0 parsers, please visit my last video. I am sharing the link of it in the description box, where I have discussed what are the different functions used in the LR0 parser. The function names are closure function and goto function. Also, what is the augmented grammar that is required in this. So everything I have discussed in my last introduction video, so please go and check it. Now in this session we will see how to solve the example of LR0 parser. So first of all, you have a grammar of this kind, that S derives AA and A derives again a production AA or B. So first of all, in the first step, we will create the augmented grammar. It is created like, just create a production of kind S dash derives S. So with S dash derives S, we are creating a new grammar called as augmented grammar. So now we will create the canonical atoms that are required in the LR0. So how does we create these canonical items? Just see, an item in the LR0 parser is nothing but it is represented with dot. So just see how we can create the canonical items for this entire augmented grammar. So I can do this by simply starting with this. Let us say S dash derives dot S. So when I add dot before the S, when I add dot before the S, just see, this dot is applicable to all the productions of A. Therefore, it could be like this: S tends to dot A and B. First of all, in the augmented grammar, we added the dot. We are starting to create the canonical items. Then, as dot precedes A, so we have to change the productions of S also. Similar to that, that means add dot to the productions of A as well. So S derives AA. So I have added dot before AA as well. Since you can observe, dot is preceded by A, therefore we need to change the production rule of A as well. So now it will become dot A or also we need to add dot before this production. So it becomes dot B. So in this way we have created the some of the canonical atoms for the S dash. So by doing this, we will simply add dots that will precede the different symbols or different production rules. After this, what we will create of these items, we will create the closure and goto. That means we apply function closure and goto on these items. So simply look here, if we apply input as S to this, if we apply input S to this, simply what you need to change, you need to shift this dot after the S. So when you apply S to this particular item, entire set, you will simply moving this dot to the right hand side. So the production becomes S dash derives S dot. So I have created a new production, S dash derives S dot. Dot means at the end. Next, if you apply A to this, let's see, if you apply A to this production, so what will happen? So you can observe the changes here. S derives A dot A, that means dot is moved ahead. That's it. and in the last production you can observe again like dot is preceded by a, so also we need to make changes into the a production. So we have to write a again, that is dot a or dot b, this production again, which is similar to the step number 1. When we apply small a to this, what changes are there? Just see. When we apply small a, so this production will get changed. So we observe the change like a derives a dot a, and also now dot preceded by a, again we need to add this production, that is dot a or dot b. So these are the changes observed when we apply a. And lastly, when you apply b, then what changes are there? This dot will be moved ahead of b, so it will be simply a derives b dot. So these are the changes that are observed when you apply it. Okay, so this is the outcome when we apply symbol, that we move the dot ahead, that is the right hand side, and this is called as closure and go to function. So we have created various different states, we have various transitions. We started with the augmented grammar, we applied go to function, and we formed a closure. This is go to transitions, and we form a closure. So when you get dot at the end, such a type of state is called as final state. When you get dot at the end, here dot is at the end, dot is at the end, it is called as final state. So we will try and reduce the other states also, so that dot will be at the end. So here it is not required. Now for this particular state, we will apply symbol a on it, so that this dot will shift it here. So it will be s derives a dot. So in this way, I have obtained a new state where dot is shifted to the last. Next, we will apply on this particular production, we will apply, let us say, a. We will apply a. Once we apply a, what we will get? It will be dot will be moved here, so it will be a dot a. So it is similar to this particular state, where it, the same outcome will be there, a dot a. And for this new dot, we have to have again write down the a production by following the same procedure. So for a, we will get a similar state. Now for this particular state, if we apply a over here, if we apply input symbol a over here, so what will happen? We will have this dot moved at this position, that is a dot a. So we get a similar production with a. Next, if we apply a over here, we will get a dot. So if you apply a, you will get a tends to a dot. So this type of production will create a derives a dot. Then if you apply b on it, you will get a derives b dot. So for b, you will get the same state. Also at this particular state, if you apply b input symbol, so sets. The entire thing is called as cannibal set of items. It is obtained by applying goto function and the closure function. So here you can also observe the final states, that is dot is coming here, dot is coming here, so dot is coming here and dot is coming here. Now the next step that you have to perform is just name all the states that we have obtained. So this is state I naught, then second this is I1 state, this is I2 state, this is I3 state, this is I4 state, this is I5, this is I6. So to all states you have to number starting from I0 to I6. So in that way we will have total 7 states present. So once you name all these states, you need to prepare a table. So the table will be of this kind. Just name all the state numbers, that is 0 to 6. Then you will prepare two parts of it. The part 1 will be called as action part. Part 2 will be called as go to part. So action part and go to part. So create two partitions of this table, that is action part and go to part. In the action part, you need to write down the non-terminal symbols. So which are the non-terminal symbols? I have non-terminal symbols as, let us say, A is a non-terminal. Then we have another non-terminal, that is B. And lastly, we have non-terminal called as dollar. And in the go-to part, you need to write down the variable names of the terminal symbols. So these are terminal symbols, and we have to write terminal symbols in the action, and we need to write variables or non-terminals in the go-to. So the non-terminals that you can observe, it is S and A only. So the non-terminals are A and S only. So in this way, just prepare the table for action part and go-to part. I repeat, action part or action section will contain only the terminal symbols, and go-to section will contain the non-terminal symbols. So now in the table, that is action and go-to part, we will find out the transition made from each state to another state, and with which symbol that transition is made. So for an example, if you observe, if we start with state number 0, we will fill all the part. So 0 on symbol S, 0 on symbol S is moving to the I1 state. So for 0 on symbol S, I am moving to the state number 1. Similarly, 0 on input A, it is moving to the I2. So we will write the 2 over here. Next, 0 on non-terminals, 0 on A and 0 on B. So whenever you are finding any transition with input symbol as the terminal symbols, that is A and B, so in that case it is referred as shift operation. So you need to write it in with a convention that suppose I0 on terminal symbol A is moving to I3. So it is nothing but the shift operation. So write S and 3 for it. Similarly, I0 on input symbol B, it is moving to the I4. So write down S4, that is shift to the fourth state. In this way, we have completed. Now, I will talk about the I1 later on. Before that, I will finish the remaining states. Let us consider I2. I2 is having two transitions, that is A. Sorry, three transition, I2 on A, A on I2 and B on I2 and A again terminal symbol A on I2. So for the two, for the terminal symbol A, it is moving to the I3. So state number 2, terminal symbol A, so it is shift 3 again. Terminal symbol B, I2 on B is going to I4, so it is again coming to the 4. And on A, that is variable A, it is going to I5, so I am writing simply state number. Next, state number is 3. 3 is having transition on E and B, also on A. So I3 on terminal symbol A is the same state, so it will be S3. I3 on terminal B, I4, so it will be S4, and I3 on A, it will be I6, that is 6th step. So in this way, we have completed all the actions taken by the terminal symbols, and with the non-terminal, the go-to operations we have written. Now, for the states similar to I1, I5, I6 and I4. In these states, you can observe we have reached to the final state, that means dot is at the final state. So let us consider the I1. In the I1, you can observe S dash derives S dot. That means S dash can see what S is. We have already derived the S. So as per the bottom up parsing, we have already derived the starting symbol. That means our string is passed. After S, there is a dot. That means what? The string which will be accepted. If you are reaching to this particular state, that means string is accepted. So for 1, there is no such transition, but on $, it will simply accept the string. Similarly, for the remaining states, that is I4, I5 and I6, again dot is moved at the end. So it is nothing but the presence of a reduce operation. So we will write instead of S, we will make use of convention, that is R and the state number. So we will write the state number. So before that, just understand what we have to write over there. Instead of writing the state number, we will write the production number. So for simplicity, I'll just name the production. So here S derives AA will be production 1. Then A derives AA will be production 2. And A derives B will be production number 3. So in this way, I'll simply name the production. And instead of state, we have to write the production. So let us say for the I4. At the I4, you can observe this is the I4. We have B. So B is nothing but the third production. So simply write down R3 in all the column values. Okay. So for I4, we derived B. B is nothing but the third production. So for all action part, write down that particular production number with the operation reduce. Similarly for I5, you have obtained AA, that means the first production rule. So write down the R1 in all the action part. And for the 6th, you obtained AA, that is the second production. So write down R2 in all the part. So in this way, action and go to part is prepared. So once you have completed the entire part, we will move to the actual examples based on this. I'll repeat the procedure one more time. We have started with the initial grammar, then we converted that grammar into the augmented grammar, then we started the process of creating canonical sets by putting the dot. So just convert the initial grammar by putting the dot, and then apply the various terminal as well as non-terminal symbol and obtain the various set. So entirely we obtain the canonical collection of items, and we have applied the go-to operation and perform the closure. Go-to operation and closure. In this way, we got the entire canonical collection of the items. After that, we switch to this table creation. This is called as parsing table. The parsing table has two major parts, that is action part and go-to part. In the action part, we have the transition listed based on the terminal symbols, and in the go-to part, we have transition listed based on the non-terminal parts. If you have terminal symbol and the state shift, then it is denoted as a shift one. If you have reached to the end state, that final state, then it will be called as radio state because we cannot see after that. So it will be denoted as R symbol. In this way, the action part and go-to part is prepared, and the entire thing is called as parsing table. So in the next video, we will see how to solve the example. Hello students. Now, in the second part, we will see how to solve the example. Now, I'll just revise what we have seen till now. In the first part, we started with the grammar. Then, from that grammar, we created the augmented grammar. Then, apply the various input symbol. Apply goto function. Apply closure function. Derive the canonical collection of items. After that, create a parsing table. This entire thing is called as parsing table. And almost all LR type of parser, the parsing table is the parsing table is the only difference. How we create the parsing table, that distinguishes, we create the parsing table that distinguishes the type of a parser. So action and go to part is defined in this table. Now let us consider the input string is given to you is AABB dollar. So this is the input, and you are asked to find out whether the LR0 parser is going to accept it or not. So the meaning of LR parser is what? It is scanning from left to right, and it gets the rightmost derivation in the reverse. But the look ahead symbol is 0. That means it is not looking at the or it is not having any idea about what the next input is coming. So let us start. The stack is always filled up with the first value as the state number 0. So please remember, the stack is always filled up with the very first value as the state number 0. Now what we will do, we are at the symbol A right now. So just see, from 0 you are looking at A. From 0 you are looking at A. So you are at 0 state and you are looking at the symbol A. So just refer the parsing table. Now you are at 0 and you are looking at symbol A. What you get? You get the S3, that is shift state 3. So if you get this kind of outcome, then shift means what? Just get the symbol onto the stack. So symbol is onto the stack, and the state number, that is state number 3. I repeat one more time, you are at state 0, you are looking at input symbol A. So go to the parsing table 0 to A, you get the action as S3, that is shift the symbol. So symbol is shifted and the state number is noted here. So we are actually remembering the state number. Next, now the top of stack is 3 and you are looking at the next symbol. So A is over, now you are looking at the second A. So from parsing table, from 3, if you are looking at A, you will be again having S3, that is shift. So shift the symbol first of all. So symbol is shifted and state is also noted, that is 3. Next, you are at state number 3, top of stack, and the next input is B. So from 3, you are looking at B. So it is nothing but shift 4. So shift the symbol and note the state number, that is 4. Now, pointer is incremented, it is at last B. Now from 4, you are looking at B. From 4, you are looking at B. So, just observe, from 4, you are looking at B, you get the R3, that is reduce operation. So, there is a special way to treat this reduce operation. What you have to do is, just find out this reduce 3. That means what? It is asking you at this input symbol, you have to reduce the third production. So which is the third production? Our third production is A tends to B. This is our third production. So we have to reduce the, it says that reduce the last operation that you perform to the third production. That means it is saying us that this last operation that we perform, reduce it to the according to the third production. So B is reduced to the A. You can also this B is reduced to the A. This is the third production. So we are actually reducing this by simply considering A tends to B. Just consider this. Now for this reason, second thing that you need to take into account is once you start reducing B to the A, just check that how many symbols or variables present for this production. Say for this production we have only one symbol on the right hand side. So for one symbol you need to pop two stack contents. For one symbol you need to pop two stack contents. So I will remove this 4 and I will remove this particular B. So for one symbol, that is B, we have removed two stack contents just because the symbol itself and its state number is reduced, and push the LHS of production. So push the LHS of production, that is A. So I have pushed the LHS of production, that is A. I have popped two entries for one symbol. Now to obtain the state, just look at the last state available in the stack, that is 3. So from 3 look at the A. So from 3 look at the A. So you will see 6. From 3 look at the A, it is 6. So write down the state number as 6 for this. I hope you understand this. Now next, again we are at 6 and we are looking at still last symbol, that is B. So from 6 look at the B. So it is nothing but the R2. So what is R2? R2 is reduced to the production number 2. So what is our production? Production is this one. So reduced to the production A tends to AA. So it is actually telling us about the previous states. So it is telling us that reduce these two AA into the A. So it is telling us reduce this to the A. So this is what the reduce operation means. So now the production considered is A tends to AA. Now here you can observe two symbols are there. That means for one symbol we remove two stack contents. For two symbols we have to remove 4 stack contents. So we have to remove these 4 stack contents and push A onto the stack, that is LHS of that production. So we will remove 4 contents, that is 6, A, 3 and A, and we will push this A onto the stack. Now get the state number for this A. The state number could be the last state available in the stack, that is 3. From 3 look at the A. From 3 again look at the A, it is 6. From 3 look at the A, it is 6. So you have to push A. A is already pushed, and now push the 6, that is the state number. So in this way you have reduced it. again from 6 look at the B. From 6 look at the B. So it is from 6 look at the B. It is again giving us the R2, that is the reduced production number 2. So again similar type of step we have to perform, reduce the production number 2. So it is actually telling us reduce this AA to A. This is reduce this A and A to A. So it gives us message that reduce AA to A. So what we have to do, again we have to remove the 4 entries, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4, and in the stack you have to push the that production, that is A is pushed, and now get this state by simply considering the last state number, that is 0A. So go to the 0 on A is nothing but the 2. 0 on A is nothing but the 2. So 2 is pushed. Now we will see from 2 to the input symbol B. From 2 to the input symbol B, it is nothing but the S4. From 2, it is nothing but the S4. So S4 is shift operation. So shift the symbol. Symbol is shifted. And state is also returned. Now from 4, we are looking at the dollar. From 4, in the last state, what we did? It is 0 to A. 0 to A, we got the state number 2. Now, next is 2 to B. 2 to B, we got the shift operation. So with shift operation we inserted B, that is pushed, and recorded the state number as 4. Now we are, the pointer is shifted to the dollar since B is pushed onto the stack. Pointer is at the dollar. So now we are at 4th state and we are seeing the dollar symbol. So we are at 4th state and we are seeing the dollar symbol. So it is nothing but the reduced 3. Reduced 3, go to the third production, that is A tends to B. So the production that we need to use is A tends to B. It has one symbol, so we have to remove two stack contents. Okay, and include this A onto the stack. So A is inserted onto the stack. And remove two contents, this B and 4 are reduced. So what it has actually told us to reduce, it is saying that reduce the last shift, that is B4. So just reduce the B to A. So just reduce this B to A. Reduce this B to A. So we are reducing this B to A. Now once A is here, just go to the last state, that is 2. 2 on A. So find out 2 on A. 2 on A is nothing but the 5. So 2 on A is nothing but the 5. So 5 is added. Now you are at 5 and you are seeing the dollar. So from 5 look at the dollar. So it will be R1. So take the R1 production is nothing but R1. Reduce first production, that is S tends to A. So S tends to A. This production we have to use. Here you can see two symbols are there. So remove 4 stack contents. So remove 4 stack contents and just shift or push this symbol onto the stack. So S is pushed and remove 4 stack contents. 1, 2, 3. And 4. So 4 stack contents are removed. Now S is there, get to the last state number, that is 0. So 0 on S is nothing but the 1. So 0 on S is nothing but the 1. So we will get the 1. So now what we will do, we will see from 1 to the dollar. So from 1 to the dollar, this way. The entire string is passed and we got the output that the string is accepted. In this way you have to solve the LR0 example. So only thing is that just consider the shift and reduce operation. For shift the symbol onto the stack along with its state number. For the reduce operation, find out the which production it is asked to reduce. See how many input symbols that symbols that production rule is having. Multiply that many number by 2 and remove those many numbers from the stack. So in this way, just traverse along with the given input string, apply the required shift and reduce operation, and finally get the outcome as the acceptance of a string. Thank you so much.